So the first thing that I started doing was to design a website for my business and my brand. So understanding that the website was going to be the main hub for all of my links and accounts and content and all that, I understood, I wanted to make a good website and a professional website. So the platform I chose to use was WordPress to make my website. Also, along with that, the hosting that I would choose to go with was Bluehost, and they also, I got my URL name, domain name through Bluehost. So I like WordPress's platform, and there's a lot of plugins that you can use. So there's a lot of videos out there to show you how to use the software platform too. So that being said, there's a lot to understanding on how to build a website. I built the website in the beginning and laid out how I wanted everything, and then I used outsourcing to add different blog pictures and stuff of the more minor things that are more time consuming, and also with the things that I couldn't quite program myself and just paid somebody else to save me the time from learning how to do it when it's only going to be one thing that one time I'll use it, so it's not worth me learning how to do it myself when I can outsource that to somebody to do it real quick. So a few other things that I've integrated with my website is like having good pictures, having a good background pictures, having trust marks, telling a story through our website, having a good about page, understanding what the fold is, and how people, when they come to your homepage, before scrolling down, what they first see when they come to your page is very important. And it's got to be organized and use link building throughout the website to map out the website really good, and the layout should be directed towards your target market. With websites, the load time, some people, if your website takes too long to load, they won't even wait for it to load. So making sure that the load time is up to date is something that we're really focused on. And then having current content and quality content on our website, different fresh type of content, all that type of content stuff is where that's all going to be hosted. So easy to navigate to, like I said, and that kind of works with the functionality of the whole website in general. And with that, sometimes we just wanted to simplify it and not make it too overcomplicated for people to use. Sometimes the simpler, the better. So, that being said, just to the point and to the content and to the videos and all that type of stuff, the blogs and all that. So, we definitely wanted to make it look professional. That includes, the pictures and, the wording and all that type of stuff. So, make sure all your spelling and everything's correct on your website. So, two other things, you might not think of that I had to do was, making a terms and conditions page, a payment policy, a shipping policy, return policy, copywriting, integrating ads on the website, having it like an auto slideshow. As I said, yeah, making sure spelling and grammar is all good. Having a calendar of events and different things on the calendar people can follow along with when stuff's going to be posted or coming out. A virtual tour of the inside kind of the business on like the home page is kind of a cool thing we've integrated. Yeah, having a place for email people to subscribe is important. That should be right on your home page, easy for people to find. Another good thing you can do is have an announcement bar for when we have new blogs or posts coming out at the top, so people can easily find the new content that we have come out. Also, I have my Amazon affiliate banner links and all that stuff, the affiliate links integrated throughout the home page and different pages on the website. So building a portfolio on the website is important. offering discount codes and coupon codes for the other products we sell on our site is important. You know, showing different charts, it's more just like a visual backup for people. Making sure it's got good browser compatibility with all different browsers people use, and that it works with phones and everything comes in how it should on the different browsers and devices people use. So, you know, having good link colors and setting up our RSS syndication with it is another thing we use. A way to get the audience involved is having polls that we'll set up on our site. Right now we don't have a members only page, but that's something we plan on implementing for paid members, that to get special unique content just for the paid members. So that's something we definitely plan on adding in the future. Going through the website every once in a while, making sure all the links work and there's no dead links, is very important. You don't want people clicking on links that you have there and they don't go to anything anymore. So make sure to check for dead links. Having a good sidebar on each blog post and category page and everything like that is very important. That's something we focused on. And having good headers and footers is also very important. Having a search bar on each page for people to be able to search your blog for, you know, certain things they're looking for is very important. I think that each page should have one of those, and or put it in your sidebar. Having donation buttons, just great, you know, easy to find for people want to donate to you. I mean, you know, might as well have an easy button for them just to click and donate to you, and you can link up PayPal and all that to that. So along those lines, is having just like a one-click checkout button is pretty cool and helps people, you know, purchase stuff faster, and, you know, just streamlines it for them. And setting up shopping carts for people to be able to purchase stuff from your store is important. Having more sign-up forms for your email and all that on different pages is important. And then getting subscribers, you know, having a place for people to subscribe to your blog to build up that social you know, standing or whatever. Connecting your PayPal is going to be important. Having a new product bar we implemented. Having a Google checkout is something else you could do. Using keywords is going to be very important. And that's kind of along the lines of SEO, which I'll get to. Having examples of your newsletter is something people can view and see if they want to join the newsletter. Keep going down here. There's a few more things that you need to know about that I found is making sure, you know, your website's secure and all that good stuff, which you know, is very important. That considers like SSL certificates and stuff like that. So make sure your website's all secure. And SEO is, you know, the way when people search Google and find your site, you got to have good SEO, search engine optimization, so people can find your site and stuff that you're posting on there. So make sure you know all about that. And optimizing the site always is something that we try to maintain as much as we can. And like I said earlier, just being easy to navigate through the site and having a good site map is something that we focus on. So we also have PDFs that people can download from our blogs if they need, like, the parts layout or a template or, you know, a schematic or something. They can print the PDFs right from our website and blogs. So that's kind of a cool feature we have. And, our overall scheme, color scheme, you know, we fit in with our brand and, like, you know, keeping our branding all going. So, you know, having our logo and slogan and same fonts and font sizes and homepage, backlinks, all that type of good stuff. So we have a blog tab, you know, podcast tab, a photos tab, a contact page tab, our affiliate links throughout the pages and different categories and stuff. So having a back to the top button is also important. A lot more to building a website and understanding all the different plugins and connecting everything. So understanding how websites work is a very important aspect to having a business nowadays. And, you know, understanding that you might not be able to do all the things for your website, but knowing how to do a lot of it will help you understand how websites work and all that stuff. And it'll give you a good background and knowledge into your business. So there's a lot more to building a website, but these are some of the things I started focusing on when I first was creating my website. So that is that for right now. Just a few things I wanted to share on how I created my website.